Just trashed it a little bit, and they knew exactly what parts to take away so that it will not work anymore. So although there is lights on, it doesn't function.
Okay. So.
But KGB here in the hotel had two missions. First thing was to listen what the tourists are telling in the rooms. Another thing was to have a radio connection. Actually, this room here was a radio room, and this was a radio relay center. From here, it was possible to have connection between Moscow and Helsinki. So from here, cable went to Moscow and radio waves to Nordic countries, mostly to Helsinki, where there was an embassy. And there was the first department of KGB working here, who was responsible for creating government connection. And it was built here in 1975, because then there was big European security summit in Helsinki. And also Brezhnev went there and he had this secret nuclear luggage, so it was very important to have connection. And actually we don't know how this room looked like, because nobody was allowed to come. Only our maintenance manager, who was here in the already from the beginning. One time he came inside, because the door was not closed. And he stepped inside, well, he was pushed outside very fast with a gun. But he managed to see there was another radio station next to this wall, so there are still some hangars.
Yes.
And there was 3-4 guys sitting inside with the headphones. So most probably there was also a connection with all the Soviet spies working in the Nordic countries.
Okay.
And we have kept this room in a way that KGB left it in 1991, because as we don't know how this room looked like, we don't want to build a Disneyland. So we want to keep it as original as possible.
Okay.
Even the cigarettes in the ashtray are still there.
Wow. They, so they are allowed to smoke?
Yes.
Because normally are American, the cigarettes. So.